Maybe. Meh. Ah, I know exactly what to choose. Garbage! Hey, structure friend. Do you have a garbage problem on Earth? So much garbage!
It's not flying around, but we definitely have a garbage problem on Earth.
Can you tell me more for my report?
Every year, each American produces over 1,600 pounds of garbage. Some of it goes to a landfill where it's dumped in a hole. And some of it goes to an incinerator where it is burned.
Why is there so much garbage?
We love buying things. And the more we buy, the more garbage we create. We make more garbage now than ever before.
I have an idea. Let's run a simulation to see what would happen if you made no garbage.
Activate simulation!
When garbage is buried in a landfill, chemicals from the buried garbage can leak into surrounding soil and water. When garbage is burned, toxins are released into the air. If you didn't make any garbage, there would be less pollution, and every living thing would enjoy safer drinking water and breathe cleaner air. Litter is garbage thrown on the ground. Whee! Any litter that ends up in the lakes and rivers will find its way to the ocean. And by the year 2025, there could be more garbage in the ocean than fish. Animals sometimes eat pieces of garbage by accident. It's hard for sea turtles to tell plastic bags and jellyfish apart. If you didn't make any garbage, the ocean would be safer for all marine plants and animals. People around the world throw about 1/3 of their food in the garbage. If you didn't make any garbage, you would only buy the food that you need. Extra food would be donated to food banks. Food that you can't eat, like banana peels and eggshells, would be allowed to rot and turn into compost. This compost would then be added to gardens to help nourish growing plants. Half of all plastic objects were designed to be used only once. This plastic bag? Once. This plastic fork? Once. Americans use about 500 million straws every single day. If you didn't make any garbage, you would use reusable items like cloth bags and refillable water bottles. Do you always need to be wearing the latest fashion? People are buying so many clothes that 85% of all clothing ends up as garbage. If you made no garbage, you would fix holes in your clothes instead of throwing them out. If you got bored of your clothes, you would trade them with friends and family. And you would transform worn-out clothing into something new, like a bag.
We should follow the three R's: reduce, reuse, recycle. First, reduce what you use. Second, reuse what you can. Third, recycle what's left. In one Japanese town, people divide their garbage into 34 categories. They carefully reuse, compost, and recycle 80% of their garbage. This is how we could all make a difference.
I'm doing my part. Bye!
I'll try harder as well. And Cosmo, nice hat.
Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Hey everyone, Cosmo here. It might be difficult to stop making garbage altogether, but we can all work together to make Earth a little cleaner. What if you went plogging? Plogging combines jogging or walking with picking up garbage. Step 1. Find an adult. You can also grab a friend or a relative to join the fun. Step 2. grab a garbage bag and some gloves. Step 3, pick a route. Do you know a nearby spot with lots of litter just waiting for you to pick it up? Step 4, go plogging. You could have a competition to see who can collect the most garbage. You'll enjoy some exercise, breathe the fresh air, and leave the environment cleaner and safer for everyone. Step 5, when you're done plogging, sort out the recyclables and put them in the recycling bin. The Earth thanks you, and I'll see you next time on What If Kids? Goodbye!